Hey guys, today I'm going to be talking about how to maximize your Google Calendar / how to become more productive / just overall how to make yourself a happier person. I've been using Google Calendar for about 4 years now. I started when I was a freshman in college. So through my years of using Google Calendar, I definitely think I've explored the nooks and crannies of what this application can do. Begin the video just by telling you the straight facts of Google Calendar, and then towards the latter half of the video I'm going to show you guys how I actually integrate it and how I actually use the application. Some of the things that won me over immediately is just how easily integrated it already is with a lot of these applications or websites. So with that being said, since it's already integrated, it makes life so much easier. Another thing with Google Calendar is you can constantly set recurring events. So if you have a weekly meeting with your boss, you can just set that as a recurring event, and the same link to the conference video call, the location, it'll show up at every single week. So you don't have to manually go back every week and input that event. You can just set it to recurring weekly. And slowly but surely, I have brought Google Calendar and let it creep up on some of my friends, because all the things that I plan, integrate that all with Google Calendar. So I'll list all the event details, I'll list the location, the time, whatever, the guest list. It'll all be listed on my event for Google Calendar. So what that means is that the other party has to physically say yes or no to going to the event. And on top of that, because Google Calendar is already integrated with your email, if you have a Gmail account, then it'll nudge you and basically send you notification emails 30 minutes before the event. I like that it already disperses the emails for you. So once again, that takes the work off of my load. But something else I've done with Google Calendar, and I've been a little sneaky, is if I'm doing an event, so let's just say I'm doing like a paint night with my house, is if I notice a lot of the girls haven't responded or RSVP'd yet, I'll start changing around a little bit of the Google Calendar event. I'll start adding more things to the description, and then there's an option, it asks, Google Calendar asks you if you want to send these new updated results to the rest of the people on the invite list. And in that way, I'm being less explicit. So once again, that's just a little nudge on their end to see if they do anything about it. If they notice that I did a change to the event, and maybe they'll be like, oh shoot, I didn't respond to her event yet. So rather than composing an email that lists all the people on your guest list, you can go straight into the Google Calendar event and just start making some changes. And so this gets rid of the fuss of opening up chat box or even creating an email thread. Rather than typing some changes up in the event details, and then Google Calendar will automatically disperse that email notifying your guest list of the results. And then on the other end, if I get invited to events, let's say through Facebook, I'll easily take all that information that was already listed on the Facebook event page and immediately transfer that over to my Google Calendar. Oftentimes in the past, pre-Google Calendar days, I'd be like scrolling through so many notifications and wondering like, where did that email go of the event list? Because I can't find the address. Ever since introducing Google Calendar into my life, when I get a Facebook event, I immediately take the location, the time, the date, and I'll integrate that into an event on my own Google Calendar. In the description, I'll write other things that I probably would forget. So I'll put stuff like, do I need to bring a platter of food? Let's just say it's a potluck. Or do I need to bring a gift? Do I need to bring some speakers? Maybe the host asked me to bring something for her or him. So I'll immediately put that right into my Google Calendar event. When I open it up on my phone, my mobile application, or even my desktop, all that information I would possibly need to see is right there. Well, you guys are probably wondering, how is that any different from just opening up your Facebook event? And while it isn't really much different, for me, because I'm already actively using Google Calendar all the time, I don't want to have to fuss through opening Facebook, which I rarely go on, but scrolling through multiple notifications until I finally get to the event notification that I got like weeks back. So further expanding on the point of utilizing the description box in your event, what I use the description box a lot for is for grocery lists. So I'll put in grocery shopping. And then while some people might go to a separate app, maybe write in their notes app all their grocery lists, or some people, if you're old fashioned, you might even write out your grocery list. But instead, what I do is I just type up my grocery list right in the event. It's so easy for me to just open the app, open the event. So once again, that's just allowing me to be more productive and efficient with my time. Okay, so now in this portion of the video, I'm gonna talk about how I set up my Google Calendar. So I broke it up into four parts. The first part, which I call the skeleton, is basically daily events that are pretty mandatory that you find of high importance. So for mine, when I was in college, high importance was obviously going to class, going to my university job, and then hitting the gym. So those were probably the three main things I always tried to get into my calendar, and that would be my skeleton outline of the schedule. So your second step is now integrating your day-to-day or weekly tasks. So some of these might include grocery shopping, company meetings, or recurring catch-up calls. So now that I'm graduated college, it's harder to keep in contact with a lot of my friends. So what I'll do for some friends is I'll set up recurring events on Google Calendar where we'll just catch up for an hour. And whether that's on phone or whether that's through Google Hangouts, through Zoom, like I said, you can all include the links of the video conferencing call or the video chat link into the event and then invite the guest. So this makes it really easy for the other party, because once they go into the event, which will show up on their calendar as well, they can just go straight to the link and then be added to the call immediately rather than having to open up a chat box and just deal with all that fuss. Okay, the third process is I call fun time. So this might be girls' night outs, paint nights, just hangouts, eating together, having lunch together, having coffee together. And I've mentioned this in a few other videos, but I can't stress enough the importance of putting in fun time into your Google Calendar. I think there's this misconception that Google Calendar has to explicitly be all about productivity, but that's not the case at all. I think Google Calendar is really good at allowing you to see visually the balance that you have in your lifestyle. So if you find yourself just going from 8 a.m. to 8 p.m., just stacking your schedule with just work things, you're gonna burn out very quickly. And I had to learn that the hard way. Again, if that means that you designate a scheduled time for watching Netflix, do it. And I think there's two ways to see this. If you find that you're scheduling so many hours, let's say like 3 hours, 2 hours a day, just watching Netflix, when you see in the grand scheme of things in the whole week's layout and you accumulate how many hours you put into Netflix, it might be a wake-up call for you. But on the other end, if you see it as more a way of, okay, this is my time of detoxing, unwinding because I worked really hard Monday through Wednesday, so Thursday night I deserve a break. And then my fourth step is habits that you possibly want to build on. So in my Google Calendar, in the current moment, I have a section for when I wake up, and I also have a section for when I do quiet time. Quiet time basically for me just means journaling for an hour. In the past, I've done events recurring daily that it used to be like walking, because I wanted to get in the habit of getting some cardio in the mornings. So I used to set times from like 7 to 8 a.m. that I would go walk. And it's not necessarily saying that just because it's in my calendar, I'm going to do it, but it's that subconscious, it's that knowing that you have a notification indicating that you should probably walk right now. So knowing that you acknowledge it, and if you decide to do it or if you don't, that's fine, but just the idea that you see the notification and it might be a trigger for you. Okay, and the fifth step is quite optional, but I have found that this has really been a game changer for me, and I start to input my tasks actually into my Google Calendar. So I know some people use a separate to-do list of just their daily tasks that they want to accomplish for the day, but I mentioned this in my previous video, but I physically go to the extent of writing in my tasks that I want to accomplish throughout the day and disperse it and pepper it throughout my day. The whole thing with this is that psychologically, if you budget time and if you already went to the extent to already make time to accomplish this task, you're more prone, or at least you'll get a trigger to actually do it. Rather than if it's in a separate to-do list that's in a completely separate area, not related to your calendar, you might easily forget this. My camera battery died before I was able to do an outro, but like always, I really hope you guys took something out of this video, whether it's even just exploring Google Calendar, not necessarily committing, or maybe you're fully convinced and want to now integrate this into your schedule and into your lifestyle. I can tell you and I can assure you firsthand that this has been a huge, huge, huge change in my lifestyle
for the better, and I can't really imagine ever not having a calendar. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I'll catch you guys in my next video. Bye!